before 21, semua te gute 1 million, jalan mate. No? Jalan pun mate. Adam pun.
Today, if I don't make 1,000, I'll not come back.
My name is Hamza, and entrepreneurship is like a sport to me. God said in the Quran, and we will surely test you with something of fear and hunger and loss of wealth and lives and fruits. I clearly identify what God is testing me with, fear of not being successful in the future. I know this because my dad called me Ambios boy the other day. If you ask Ibrahim about pups, he will tell you. The thing about pups is that even if you kill a lion with your hands, you'll be like, ah, this generation's lions are vegetarians and they are lazy. They are not even hungry. So once he told me that, I was like, confirmation. But anyways, can I build a company that could make me $1.5 billion in profit per year living in the Gambia? That's what I want to find out. I have 3 solid business plans, which I'm going to share later in the video.
Growing up in the Gambia, I used to hear myths like, Gambia has no money. This economy is dry. No one ever got rich in this country, and no one can get rich in this country. All the rich people got rich outside.
While some of these myths might definitely be true, I want to find out whether this particular one is true or not. Can I make it in the Gambia if I am willing to give it all I got? I mean, everything I got.
Even though I started dozens of small businesses and side hustles from the age of 13 to 19, I believe in this myth. I was here doing businesses, but my hope was not here. When I envision myself in the future, I don't see myself in this country. The goal was pretty simple. Make some money and bounce to countries with more opportunities. So in all my business ventures, I don't look at it as this is my future $1 million business. I look at it as this is the business that is going to give me enough money to live. Not back way, by the way. I love my life too much to take that risk. We will tell ourselves once we get rich, we'll come back to our country and invest. Maybe that's the right approach. I don't know. I'm just a 20-year-old high school dropout trying to figure out what to do with my life. But I think I was brainwashed, or not, by people's opinion. It's crazy how people's opinion can shape your mindset. Let me tell you a quick story. I tried making money from the internet for a whole year, but nothing was working. But within that year, sometimes I would be so broke, I would be like, okay, today I gotta hit the street. I'll make promises to myself, if I don't make 1K, I will not come home.
Yo, I'm starting my carpet business today. And today, yeah, if I don't come back with 1,000, today if I don't make 1,000, yeah, I'll not come back. Matter what, bro, today, real serious tactics, innit?
Then get up on my chair and hit the streets. I can vividly remember this day I made around 1,600. Not much, but that could do for a broke high school dropout with no skills. Just willing to grind. I didn't steal it, by the way. I will just go around the neighborhoods, knock on doors, and wash their carpets. But after 1 week of doing that, I stopped and went back to trying to build an online business. Because you can't get rich in this country mentality got me. What gave me the idea and the confidence to document myself trying to build a multi-million dollar company in the Gambia is that last 2 weeks I messaged my brother telling him that I learned cool stuff about business which I'm going to implement in his canvas and framing business. Within 1 week of implementing what I learned, the business 5x its profit, which got me thinking, are we really trying? No, to be frank, are we really trying to make it out here? Or are we just lazy and want the easy way out? How many of the complainers are actually learning tangible skills and improving their knowledge? I caught myself the other day saying this country, businesses have no competition. That's why they don't care about customer service. Then I realized, this is not a problem for me. This is an opportunity. Build a similar company, create better customer service, and see what will happen. I read a similar finance book a while ago, which mentioned this point. You get rich by solving society's problem. And Naval added, you will even get richer when you give society what it wants, but doesn't know how to get. AKA, innovate, bringing something new to the country. So fellas, the next time you see a problem you can solve, it's not actually a problem to you. That's an opportunity to you. And society will reward you if you solve the problem. The bigger the problem solved, the bigger the reward.
Before I reveal my business plans / ideas, I want to tell a little entrepreneurial story of mine and what gave me the confidence to document myself trying to build a multi-million dollar company in the Gambia.
I call myself an entrepreneur because I do what big entrepreneurs, my role models, did. Like the time I decided to drop out of high school because almost all my role models are college dropouts. And I want to be like them, so I gotta do what they do, right? I dropped out of high school, but the funny thing is that I thought entrepreneurs didn't like books and this reading stuff. All they like to do and care about is chase money. But how wrong was I? Just in a period of 1 year, I read more than 30 books. That's a must, because once you start, you get even more lost, and you will need some answers to your questions. But my entrepreneurial story started way before I knew the internet existed. Ever since I was a kid, I loved the idea of making money. I'm talking 13 years back in primary school, selling candies in class. And the money I will make, I will lend some to my friends, take some of the profits, buy packages of candies on my way home at Serekunda to resell the next day. The following day, my friends will also pay me more than I lent them. I was a rich kid. I bought whatever I wanted. My small business eventually died. I can't remember why exactly. But one of the reasons is that my mom said, lending money with interest is haram in Islam and it's riba. That was my first ever side hustle. Maybe it's the feeling of making my own money or being able to buy whatever I want led me to start another business when I was 15. I saved some money and started a small poultry farm, which did really well for me at the start, but ended up being a mess. Mess as in messes. That small things that roll around your neck. My home was full of messes, so we slaughtered everything. Fun fact, I was so mad, I grabbed the last chicken left, I went to the next neighborhood and gave up on it. I threw it on the street. Then couple years later, I started a banana farm, which quickly went to shit after the landlord claimed his plot of land. And then, you get the point. I love starting a business. I was just starting these businesses with no clear goal on what I wanted to do after my education. Before starting my garden, I said I wanted to be a farmer. But after encountering the difficulties of farming, I said, nope, I don't think this is the way people get rich. So I'm going through high school, but I don't actually know what I wanted to do after my education. Until 2022, I got my first laptop and started using the internet frequently. And then I started seeing 18-year-old self-made millionaires. So this kid is telling me he makes money more than my entire bloodline combined. I said to myself, that doesn't make sense to me at the time. All I ever knew about money is that getting rich is equal to how many years you spent working on a job. If you save 10 G's every month, it will take you 8 years to make a million, without considering inflation. And I said to myself, who will even give these kids a job which will pay more than 10 G's per month? And even if they have a job that pays 10 G's per month, they will have started working since the age of 10. Well, clearly, I know there are so many things I'm missing. My curiosity started leading me into a rabbit hole of reading and learning. 6 months later, I thought I had a glitch. Why is everyone not seeing what I'm seeing? I'm going to be a millionaire before 21.
And before 21, sumate gute 1 million, No, yalla bu ma de wa dam ko mi eh 1 million bala 21 17 no I'm 18 19 20 21 3 years there dam a te 21 million hey 1 million yeah I'm seeing it my boy is not that so but so yalla na we
making this video here and promising myself was shooting myself on the foot. Or maybe not. Only time can tell. I always try to keep promises I make to myself. If these kids became a millionaire with only their laptop and an internet connection, why can't I? I have no excuse. I have a laptop and an internet connection. I believe in myself in one thing. I'm going to work harder than everyone else. I took this hustle approach because it has worked for me in school exams. Even if I don't concentrate in class or skip class, I know that when it's few weeks or months, depending on the exam's intensity, that last few weeks or months, I will study harder than everyone else and I will pass. But the problem is that you forget everything after exams. Surprise, surprise, surprise. People that study longer and harder get better results than people who don't study hard. Well, then I assume if I work harder than everyone else, I will get richer than these young millionaires. But oh boy, was I wrong. That taxi driver probably works harder than Tuff. But who is richer? You see, Tuff has something called leverage. Without leverage, you can make some money, but you cannot get rich. So anyways, around July 2022, after reading so many books and entrepreneur stories, I saw a common pattern. They were all dropouts. I didn't know why, but I want to be like them. So I gotta do what they do. So I dropped out with 1 year left before graduation. I thought I was taking a big risk, but looking back, that was no risk at all. I thought it was a big risk because, well, as we all know, school is your life. If you don't go to school, what is you doing with your life, as we hear? That is partially true, depending on the individual. Before, people used to have good jobs with a high school certificate. But then, what happened? Everyone has a high school certificate. Then it becomes invaluable because everyone has it. That's the law of economics and the law of the universe. If everyone has something, its passive value decreases. Money is valuable because not everyone has enough of it. If everyone has abundance of it, its value will diminish drastically. Last week, I saw a reel of Dr. Ismaila, also one of my role models, by the way, saying these successful companies should increase the salaries of their employees, which they should, by the way. But in economics, we were told there is a type of market where the price is determined by the market. No single individual could stand up to their boss and demand a pay raise. If lots of people are looking for that exact job and willing to do it for lower pay, and as qualified as you, your boss will just replace you if you start talking about stuff they don't want to hear. A quick word of advice to my newly graduated friends. If you don't know what to study, study something with high barrier of entry, like something really hard, a course that requires 8 years of studies or something, or a really expensive course, or a newly emerging industry which looks really complicated because most people are not willing to go through all that. I have friends, if I ask them, what's next now? They will be like, I will study this course, it's really easy and it takes 3 to 4 years to complete. Well, guess what? Thousands of people are going to study that too. Those courses are what my dad calls lazy people course. When I changed my mind on being a farmer, I didn't actually know what I wanted to do. So Pops asked me, what do you want to study? Out of the blue, I just said, marketing. I didn't actually know what's actually marketing. And he was like, okay, those lazy people course. If the supply of your job is low and the demand is high, you can stand in front of your boss and look him in the eye and tell him to double your pay. This is where I think entrepreneurs are really successful. They build a lot of skill stacks and specific knowledge. Let's not forget about the fact that they are the boss. They own the businesses and the companies. Why not try to be an employer than an employee? I get it. Too much tricks and too much work. That makes sense. But anyways, after dropping out, I went all in on trying to build an online business. I'm talking stock trading for 3 months, faceless YouTube channels, multiple channels by the way, and try to sell on eBay. We didn't get anywhere. Affiliate marketing with no audience and no money. Yeah, clearly stupid, right? And also try those obvious scam stuff, like taking surveys and taking $10 an hour. Yeah, I was really desperate. Even if luck was trying to find me, it won't see me. There are 3 types of luck. The blind luck, where you get lucky because of something completely out of your control. Just right place at the right time. Complete coincidence. And there is this type of luck called luck through persistence. This is where you run around and bump your head on every single thing until you stumble upon something that works. Exactly what I was doing. The third type of luck, luck through sense. This happens when you are good at something or you have been doing something for so long that you will spot opportunities that majority of people cannot see when they break out. This is the type of luck I'm working towards. And the fourth type of luck, luck through mastery. This is building a unique brand, a unique character, and a unique mindset, which causes luck and opportunities to find you. About exactly 1 year later, I stopped and looked at myself. You truly want to be rich with no tangible skills and no specific knowledge. Millions of people are already doing that. Why do you think luck will find you or your scenario will be different? If you do the same thing as everyone else, you will get the same result as everyone else. I stopped running around and learned video editing for 1 month. The following month, 20 G's in my bank. And the guy was definitely underpaying me. But who cares? I finally made my first penny through the internet. And then I was like, wait, you actually need to be good at something. The following month, I learned storytelling and improved my writing skills. Made this channel, upload my first video, and everyone loved it. Monetized the channel on the 13th day after uploading the video. Now I see the clear pattern. You actually need to increase your value and you will be worth more. That's why a few months later, you haven't seen me make a video. I was busy improving my value, learning business from the smartest minds in the world. Actually learning business from people who have built companies worth over $100 million. So I'm confident I can build a multi-million dollar company in the Gambia. That's why I will be documenting myself actually attempting it. I have 3 solid business ideas, and I'm going to choose one with the most probability of success and the one which has the most compounding effect. Meaning, if after 2 years the business collapses, what is it that I'm going to have with me, as in skills or knowledge, which I can easily use to climb back again? That's the type of business I'm talking about. The number one business idea, start an SSMA, which stands for Social Media Marketing Agency. What this does is increase the online presence of businesses, making video content for businesses, running ads for them, SEO stuff, managing their social media accounts. Our job is to bring a business more customers and brand awareness. Like exactly what I did to my brother's business. I love this business model because it has that sweet retainer advantage. Retainer meaning recurring clients. And the fact that I know how to write content, make contents, and edit videos. So yeah, I have a competitive advantage in this market. The second business idea is a cleaning company. I have a small business experience with this one, even though it will be harder to scale and it will involve so much management. The startup capital will be high if we want to scale really fast. If you sell the same exact thing as your competition, then price becomes the determining factor. So yeah, and the sun is going to hit you throughout the day. With all those barriers of entries, makes the business have that longevity vibes and will actually employ lots of Gambians. So yeah, I will think about it. And the third one is my brother's wall art and photo framing business, Ghana Prints. This business has been running for 4 years. We don't do marketing, just words of mouth and referrals. I think this business has so much to grow because since we started, we haven't launched any additional product or branched out to new things. Actually, we haven't put that much effort into growing the business. That's the story of most businesses in the Gambia. Most businesses are in the point where they are making okay monthly incomes. You are really not trying that hard, and you are kind of comfortable where you are at. Last week, I sent my brother a marketing plan for this business, which I learned a few months ago. I 5x our profit in 1 week, and maybe 20x our leads. One thing I now know, which I couldn't understand before, is that knowledge is better than gold and silver, as Mandela said. This sounds woo-woo-wah-wah, but it's actually true.
Among these business ideas, I don't know which one to actually go with exactly. If there is one thing I learned about business is that the product or the service you are selling is like the foundation of your business. You know, choosing the right product or the right service can build or break your business model. I will definitely take my time on this section. Over these past 2 years, I have made so many business mistakes which I'm not willing to go through again. I have identified all the problems and the mistakes which I will be sharing with you throughout this challenge. I was playing this game as an amateur, but I think it's time to level up. I have one question for you. Will you subscribe?
Keep us, great God of nations, to the game.